Myself, Akshay Kumar N. Suvade, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Department. Today, we are going to discuss shear force and bending moment diagram. At the end of this session, student will be able to determine and draw shear force and bending moment diagram for a beam. So, today we will see a problem on a cantilever AB whose end A is fixed, carries UDL over its entire length of 1 kN per meter, and at mid, at point C, there is a couple which is acting in anticlockwise direction of magnitude 20 kN meter. So, according to the sign conventions for the shear forces, when you consider the left side of the section, all upward forces are positive, all downward forces are negative. Whereas, if you are considering the right side of the section, all upward forces are negative, all downward forces are positive. Similarly, for bending moment, if you consider the section XX, all the moments which are acting to the left side of the section in anticlockwise direction and to the right side of the section in clockwise direction, these are considered to be negative and these are called as hogging moment. Whereas those bending moment which are acting to the left side of the section in clockwise direction and to the right side of the section in anticlockwise direction, they are considered to be positive and they are known as sagging moment. Now, for a while, think whether we can calculate the reaction and fixed end moment at the fixed support of cantilever. So, reaction at point A is equal to total load acting on the beam in the downward direction. Therefore, total load acting in the downward direction, 20 kN load acting at point B and UDL 1 spread over distance 8 meter. So, total load acting in the downward direction is 28 kN and therefore, reaction at A should be acting in the upward direction having magnitude 28 kN. Similarly, moment at point A. So, in order to counterbalance the clockwise moment at fixed support A, there will be anticlockwise moment. Therefore, moment at point A is equal to 20 into 8. This moment is acting in clockwise direction. So, clockwise moment we are considering positive. Then, UDL 1 kN per meter spread over distance 8 meter. And it will act as a point load at half of 8. This is also clockwise moment. And there is an anticlockwise couple acting at point C, which is minus 20 kN meter. And therefore, moment at point A is 172 kN meter acting in anticlockwise direction. And hence, fixed end moment MA is equal to 172 kN meter. Now, in order to calculate the shear forces at various points along the beam, we will consider the section XX between point C and B. So, consider section XX at a distance X from end B. And therefore, shear force at section XX is equal to, considering the right side of the section, 20 kN force acting in the downward direction, according to sign convention, it is positive. There is a UDL of 1 kN per meter spread over distance X. So, 1 into X is the total load and this total load will act in the downward direction, so considered to be positive. So, this is the shear force acting at section XX. So, this distance x varies from B to C. So when you put x equal to 0, you are calculating the shear force at point B, which is equal to 20 kilonewton. Whereas when you put x equal to 4, the shear force at point C is equal to 24 kilonewton. Similarly, when we consider the shear force between point C to A, again consider the section between A to C at a distance x from A and C. So calculate the shear forces acting to the right side of the section. So shear force at section xx when you are considering the section between A and C. Therefore, the forces acting to the right side, downward force at point B, 20 kilonewton acting in the downward direction, considered to be positive. There is a UDL, 1 kilonewton per meter, and the total span from this section xx is 4 plus x. So 4 plus x. This is also acting in the downward direction as a point load, so considered to be positive. Therefore, your distance x varies from point C to A. Therefore, when you put x equal to 0, you are calculating the shear force at point C. Again, it is 24 kilonewton. When you put x equal to 4, shear force at point A is equal to 28 kilonewton. So this is shear force calculation. Now we will draw shear force diagram. So this is your baseline. All positive values are to be drawn above the baseline and negative value below the baseline. So at point B, the shear force is 20. So due to the downward load, the shear force value will increase from 0 to 20 by vertical straight line. At point C, the shear force is 24 kilonewton. It varies linearly. So from 20, it goes on increasing to 24 kilonewton. And at point A, the shear force is 28. So again, from point C, the shear force will increase from 24 to 28 kilonewton. So this is your shear force diagram. Similarly, we can calculate the bending moment also. Consider the section between C and B and calculate the bending moment. So bending moment calculation, when you consider the section between C and B, so this is section XX considering right side. So what are the various moments to the right side of this section? So there is a point load 20, its distance from the section is x. So 20 into x, this moment is considered to be negative, so it is minus. There is a UDL of magnitude 1 kilonewton per meter spread over distance x. So 1 into x is total load, and this total load will act as a point load at x by 2 from the section, so it is again minus. Therefore, your distance x varies from B to C. So when you put x equal to 0, you are calculating the bending moment at point B, which is equal to 0. When you put x equal to 4, you are calculating the bending moment at point C, which is, by putting the value x, you will get minus 88 kilonewton meter. Now, similarly, consider the section between C to A at a distance x from A and C and calculate the bending moment. So, bending moment at section xx, when you consider the section between A and C and referring the right side of the section. So, what are the various moments to the right side of the section? This point load 20 into its distance from this section xx. So 20 into 4 plus x, this is negative. Again, there is a UDL 1 spread over distance 4 plus x, and it will act as a point load at a distance 4 plus x divided by 2. This moment is also minus. And at point C, there is an anti-clockwise couple. So, to the right side of the section, anti-clockwise moment I have considered to be positive. So, while calculating the bending moment, only magnitude of the couple is to be taken into account. So, it is plus 20. Therefore, bending moment at point C, you can obtain by putting x equal to 0. So, bending moment at point C at x equal to 0, you will get minus 68 kilonewton meter. Similarly, when you put x equal to 4, you will get the bending moment at point A, which is by putting the value x equal to 4 meter, you will get the bending moment at point A minus 172 kilonewton meter. So, this is the bending moment calculation. Now, we will see the bending moment diagram. How the bending moment varies between point B to A. So, this is your baseline. At point B, the bending moment is 0 and it goes on decreasing to minus 88 kilonewton meter at point C. Due to the couple acting at point C, there is a sudden change in the bending moment from minus 88 to minus 68 by vertical straight line. And from minus 68, again it goes on decreasing to minus 172 kilonewton meter. So, from this diagram, we can see at the section where couple acts, there is a sudden change in the bending moment, and that change in the bending moment is equal to the magnitude of the couple. The material which is referred for this particular problem is from SS Bhavikatti, Strength of Material, S. Chan, Private Limited, 4th edition. Thank you.